Well, three quarters of a century after its invention, we have a Panjandrum. And as I'm sitting on this thing, I feel like I'm about 4 years old because its size is so gargantuan. And I can only imagine that the builders of the real Panjandrum felt the same way, like had the same kind of laughter at the simplicity and absurdity of this perfect solution. Big wheels for getting over big obstacles. The only question I have about its functionality are these rockets. Can we get all 32 of these rockets to fire simultaneously? That's the next thing we have to test.
Rocket technology took a giant leap forward in World War II when German military scientists developed the first gyroscopic guidance system capable of guiding their V-1 buzz bombs precisely to their targets. Unfortunately for the designers of the Panjandrum, British engineers never quite got the hang of rocket technology during the war.
So right now, we are gearing up to just do an ignition test. The most complicated part of the original Panjandrum is the rocket ignition system. The difficulty is that there's 32 rockets, which means 32 separate igniters. All of them have to be wired to two separate common, one hot, one ground. You've got to get them all to light up simultaneously. Is it red, black, green, white?
Yes.
The thing about a system like this is that, I mean, we've got 32 rockets, so 32 igniters, 32 wires in blocks, and that's not just 32 points of failure, that's like at least 64 points of failure, because every wire has two ends. Oh, no. This is tedious work, but I also really love it. You don't get good at this kind of work without loving it. I mean, you have to kind of give over to the tedium, to the zen, to that level of concentration required to make sure that you have properly checked everything.
Sometimes the best way to mitigate failure is good old-fashioned attention to detail.
Seems good.
Deal.
Are we almost ready to do a test of these?
Yes, we are.
If it's successful, all 32 of these are gonna catch on fire and show us that we have enough power and our system is correctly wired to ignite 32 rockets. Here we go, launch test in 3, 2, 1. Happy birthday.
One of my favorite parts, checking the high-speed camera. Now I'm looking here to make sure that ignition is as close as possible on all 32 initiators. Oh, wow, what a fireworks show! From the first to the last initiator, not more than 150 milliseconds elapsed. That is about an eighth of a second, and that is totally within the realm of simultaneity that I was looking for. Yes, simultaneity is a word.
Looking at the old footage of the Panjandrum, my eyes tell me that the primary culprit in most of the failures was likely a failure of simultaneity. Hopefully, that's at least one potential problem we can check off our list. But this was just a bench test. It's time to take our Panjandrum out to the field and fire this sucker off for real.
It's P-Day. It is time to finally light up our Panjandrum in this beautiful, grassy, flat field on the Pacific coast, about 50 miles south of San Francisco, is the perfect location for our launch. Now, we have replicated in every way our Panjandrum to match the original. 10-foot diameter wheels, 6 feet apart, 32 rockets powering them. And the real one would have had thousands of pounds of TNT in the middle.
It has the igniter
already in, so
already
that comes
good,
out like this.
Good to go.
The 32 rockets we're using to power this Panjandrum are the best analog we could find for the original rockets, and they're not called like H motors.
Time to install some actual rockets.
All when right, ignited simultaneously, these H motors should provide roughly 300 pounds of thrust and hopefully propel our Panjandrum forward at about 20 miles per hour. As we learned in our small-scale tests, simultaneous ignition and balanced power on each wheel is critical.
Every single failure I can see in the footage of those British beaches shows rockets misfiring or misbalanced Panjandrums, where a bunch of rockets are firing on this side and not the same amount on that side.
The logistics of this puppy are starting to really sink into me. 32 rockets, 32 fuses, landing crafts crossing the English Channel full of soldiers, sea spray. Just getting this candle to light on time would have been a logistical nightmare. These are the last two. 64 separate connections, 32 rockets, 300 pounds of starting force. Let's light this candle. There it is.
Good, good. The strap is free.
Let's run the wires in the quick release.
Okay.
Doing a final eyeball check. All these connections look good.
I'm kind of curious about what it's going to do. Is it going to just fire right into the Pacific Ocean? Is it going to turn into a spinning top of death that kills us all? Or more astonishingly, might it just travel in a straight line right towards our target? Frankly, I really don't know, but there's only one way to find out.
We've set up our mock World War II battlefield, complete with anti-tank Czech hedgehogs, tangles of barbed wire, and our representation of the Nazis' Atlantic seawall.
Here's what's gonna happen. I'm gonna head down there to that spool. Crew's gonna get to a safe position. And on the radio, I'm gonna count down 3, 2, 1 and push this beautiful shiny red button. When I do, a relay will shunt power from a car battery to 32 rocket igniters. An initial half-second force of 300 pounds will start our Panjandrum going. And for the next 15 seconds, 100 pounds of force will keep it rolling, hopefully all the way through our target. And then there'll be some cheering. Or if anything goes not according to plan, I've got a big green tractor to hide behind. All right, let's go.
Launch box is plugged in.
Arming the box. We are armed. Firing the Panjandrum. And 3, 2, 1. Go, 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 go. Come on, baby, come on. We just had 32 perfect ignitions, and we got a perfect launch.
Okay, our rockets didn't have quite enough force to really drive our Panjandrum all the way to our seawall with devastating momentum. Plus, our aim was a little off, and we only managed to nick our seawall. Sure, we could keep adjusting for the perfect balance of power and thrust forever, just like they attempted and failed to do in World War II. But my gut tells me that we need a better propulsion system.